June 19th, I had my both breasts removed and I had reconstruction done. Nobody told me that I'd wake up in extreme pain. I knew they were stretching my muscle forward, but I had no idea the pain I would endure, nor did I know that it would be done, that severe pain would be done in 24 hours. I would go home. I don't want to say it was isolating, but I was home alone. My husband would come home and drain my tubes from work because we're very close to our business. And I slept most of the first week. After that, it was just about getting better. My goal was to just feel better, to feel better. I was excited to have the implants put in. I had no idea the implants wouldn't look natural. I didn't know there'd be a lot of discomfort with the implants. I didn't know that every time I flexed my muscles, I called it a He-Man chest. It made me very self-conscious. Bending over if I had a V-neck top on. And so this year in July, it was a 6-month mark, and I was ready to tell Dr. Doubek, take them out. I don't want them anymore. The discomfort was not just distracting, but it was, I'm not gonna say debilitating, but the pain never left. It always felt like I was bound tightly and it was borderline painful, and it wasn't worth it to have the natural look while I was dressed. I was just gonna go natural with nothing. So I came in ready to tell Dr. Doubek, take him out. And he said, funny you should say that, because there's a new procedure. He said it was about 3 to 6 months after I had mine done. He said they had a new way of doing it where they could put the muscle back on the wall of my chest where it belonged, and the implants would come out in front of the muscle.
We've been doing the pre-pectoral breast reconstructions since March of 2017. The evolution of how this breast reconstruction has come about is that back when we started doing implant and tissue fender reconstructions, they all used to be put on top of the muscle. And the outcomes were usually very, very poor because almost all those patients ended up with capsular contracture. So they had a very deformed look to their breast in that first year after surgery, because there was nothing to prevent that scar tissue from forming around the breast implants or the tissue expanders. So the next phase was to put the implants or the tissue expanders behind the muscle, so total muscle coverage. And so that included not only using the pectoralis major muscle, but also a small portion of the serratus anterior, a muscle in the lateral chest wall. The problem with that was that, again, the breast had a very flat appearance because it had the entire reconstruction was defined by the muscles themselves. So I had a very, very poorly projecting breast as a result of that. And also, it was a little bit more morbid as well because you had to lift off 2 chest wall muscles to get complete coverage. So the next phase in the evolution of breast reconstruction was to do a dual plane, and that's when that's when Alloderm came out. So we thought, instead of lifting off the serratus now, we'll give that inferior and lateral support with the Alloderm, but we'll still keep the pec in controlling the upper 2/3 of the breast implant or the tissue expander. Then the next phase was why do we even need to do the pec at all? Now we can wrap the whole thing in Alloderm. And so that's kind of the evolution. So we've gone from no Alloderm to complete coverage, dual plane, and now we're back on top of the muscle completely wrapped in Alloderm. But then you're asking, you did that 30 years ago, why don't you have the problems now? The Alloderm is preventing that capsular contracture from forming. It's not really acting like it's tissue that would normally form a contracture. So that's why it's thought to also be somewhat radioprotective as well, is because that's why patients think with Alloderm, it doesn't respond the same way to radiation as does normal tissue does. The behind the muscle reconstructions are much more uncomfortable postoperatively than the implants or tissue expanders placed on top of the muscle.
The first thing I noticed was that pain that I had was gone. And at first I was afraid to look in the mirror. I wasn't sure what I was gonna see. And I knew there was swelling, but I braved it anyway. Took my shirt off, took my sports bra off, and I said, I love my boobs. I just said, yes. I said, I mean, they're not the real me, but I feel like I can wear any dress, any top. I don't feel uncomfortable when I bend over. I actually have cleavage again.
Aesthetically, the breast implants look better on top of the muscle than behind the muscle, because when they're behind the muscle kind of defines the shape of the breast rather than the skin envelope. So the patients who have had implants or tissue expanders behind the muscle would probably be good candidates, and their number one complaints are usually chest wall tightness or chest wall pain, and they also complain of deformity of their breast implant when they contract their chest wall muscles. So those are the two reasons that we end up converting those patients from behind the muscle to on top of the muscle reconstructions. So we kind of learned, I think, in this early part of this conversion that radiation patients are probably not going to be considered as either conversion patients or prepectoral patients up front. It's an outpatient surgery. The conversion usually takes only about 2.5 hours to do, and they really have almost no restrictions in their activities post-operatively. And that includes lifting restrictions, resuming activities of daily living, and typically no drains. These patients use much less pain medication post-operatively.
I realized when I had my original surgery, that's as far as medicine and science had taken reconstruction. And I was grateful for that. But to all the people in the field of medicine and science that keep pushing to find something better, always better, I don't even know how to say thank you to those people. And I'm so grateful, and I've told many people that all the different people in the medical profession, I hope they know that they're very appreciated and loved by people like me.